What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more Tears for Fears, and we're going through their Seeds of Love album, 1989. Getting near the end of it. It is a shorter album in terms of the number of songs, though I do have to point out, I've noticed multiple songs have been, you know, 6-7 minutes in length. It's still a very full record. It just has, you know, fewer chapters and longer and more sort of expansive chapters, if you will. So, yeah, shout outs to them for the sort of construction and composition of this album. Very much enjoying it. I mentioned when I finished the last reaction, which is Standing on the Corner of the Third World, once again, shout out to that song title. Just really like the crafting of that, and I really did enjoy the song. It had sort of like some jazzy elements, and it was sort of like, you know, an evolution. It was a very sort of like progressive tune. But yeah, I did mention that I don't know, at least by name, any of the remaining songs. And someone commented, like, the remaining three are all fantastic. And I think more than one person has commented on the last song in particular, Famous Last Words, so I'm really looking forward to getting to that one. But before we get there, we have a couple more to go, the first one being Swords and Knives. I mentioned it at the end of my last reaction. It has sort of an edgy, you know, potentially even ominous kind of sound, but we'll have to see how it manifests, and obviously it could be used as a metaphor or even, you know, in a sort of unexpected way. Sometimes you can take a concept that is known and sort of stereotyped in one way and sort of turn it on its head, and it could be sort of illuminating in a semantic or artistic way. So let's see what it's all about. Once again, shout out to the disc and the physical release. As I said, you know, I try to remember to show the physical media on this channel. But yeah, so this is Swords and Knives by Tears for Fears on their 1989 album, The Seeds of Love. Like we were about to shift there, yeah. It kind of hung in the air for a moment. Oh my god, that's in the guitar.
like the now kind of halting, stagnated rhythm, and then back into the full procession. Resolute. Ooh, I like that. Those guitar legs sort of like echoing over the top of the track. Feels like this album, it's blended different flavors, like jazz, rock. I think there's still some synth work in there. Vangelis, I don't know how you say that. The guitar. The compositional sense is top notch. Like every time I feel like it's maybe about to do something, it'll do it, but even more significantly than I realize. Admittedly, I'm still not picking up a lot of the lyrics. I do apologize. Sometimes on a first listen, music hits me more than lyrics, but. Back to the next song, I'm gonna back cue it about 10 seconds before the end there and let it bleed into the next one, because I feel like there was a progression there, an intentional linking of the two tunes sonically. So yeah, looking forward to that. The next tune is, what is it again? Year of the Knife. So yeah, we'll see what that one's about. And again, Swords and Knives, and you sonically connect it to another tune called Year of the Knife. I am very intrigued by that. So yeah, we'll come back for that. Let me know what you think. Big ups to Tears for Fears again. Love this group. Big ups to Oleta Adams. She wasn't as all over that track as she has been on a couple others, but when she showed up, the power and quality that I now have come to expect was absolutely there. So yeah, let me know what you think of the song. Let me know if you do have some insight on the lyrics. Let me know if that sort of, just that little theme that maybe I picked up on the end, let me know if I'm onto something there, or if maybe, that wasn't quite what he said, or if I'm just kind of missing the mark. Always interested to hear other opinions or, more accurate information when it comes to songs I haven't heard before. So, yeah, big ups to all of you who have been watching and commenting on these Tears for Fears videos. Have a good day, have a good night, and I'll see you next time.